Today you will learn how to edit a documentary style interview and make it look seamless in post, even though you have two different camera angles. The first one, the A cam, being the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 6K, and the second one, which is right up here, is the Panasonic Lumix G85. But first, if you want to edit and practice with me, with the footage that I use in this tutorial and in the coming tutorials, feel free to join my channel membership program, because alongside various other different benefits, all of my channel members will get a download link to the practice footage that I use in all of my tutorials so they can work alongside with me. If that's something you might be interested, feel free to check out my channel membership program. The link is in the description down below. Before we start out, I highly recommend you to create a couple folders in your media pool for the A cam, the B cam, and the audio, and then put the media in accordingly. So then what I want you to do is go to your A cam folder, then drag the A cam onto the first clip. By the way, this is just how I edit like interview styles. I'm not sure if that's the right way. It's just the way that I personally use and it works great. Then go to your B cam folder, drag the B cam clip and put that on top of the A cam clip, and then go to your audio and put that on the bottom layer. Then what I want you to do is highlight all of the clips, including all of the audio files, right click and then select auto align clips based on waveform. Now that Resolve has done its magic, all of the clips are synced up perfectly. And that's due to one single tip that I highly recommend you to do if you shoot a interview style like this. Let the A cam, the B cam, and the audio roll, and then tell your subject or yourself to double clap. This makes aligning the clips just a little bit more simple, as you can see right here. Everything's lined up and synced perfectly. So then what I want you to do is I want you to make a cut where you start talking, because chances are that we don't need any of this again. So what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna hit my W key, because my W key is assigned to cut the footage, everything that is highlighted, and then I'm gonna delete the first part. So once we've done that, on audio layer number 3 is the clean audio that I recorded via an external recorder. So then what I want you to do is just highlight audio layer number 1 and 2 and delete them as well. Right now, select the audio layer number 3, hold the shift key, and now you can just move this up. And when you hold the shift key and move this up, you can't put that left and right. You can just move this up and down, but not left to right, which is great to not messing up the audio once again. So the next thing that I want you to do is, if you're working with my files or with your files and you have a mono clip, as I have right here, as you can see in the mixer, only the left part is bumping up.
Two different cameras.
So that means we have to convert that into a stereo file, and we're gonna do that by right clicking the audio, then go to clip attributes, then go to embedded channel 2, right, and embedded channel 1. So that means DaVinci Resolve is just copying the left channel to the right channel, so we have stereo audio.
And make it look seamless in post.
So then the next part is we have to find the point where I stopped messing up. So at around this point in time, I stopped messing up. We can delete all of this. So what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna go right here, I'm gonna zoom in, and I'm gonna make my audio track number 1 just a little bit bigger so I can see what I'm doing better. And then you can either make a cut right here. Again, I have assigned that cut to my W key. If you want to copy my keyboard shortcuts, then you can go to DaVinci Resolve in the top left corner, go to keyboard customization, just click on the W key, and you can see that the application is the razor command. So I'm gonna go into my search bar on the right and type in razor. And then under timeline, the razor tool is assigned to W. And whenever I hit W, this just makes a cut. And then I have assigned my Q application to start to playhead. So let's just type in start to playhead. And then under ripple, you have start to playhead, and then assign that to Q. And that basically deletes everything that is on the left side of the playhead until the next cut. And if I'm gonna go to E, this is end to playhead. So let's just and type in end to playhead and under ripple again. And this just deletes everything that is after the playhead to the next cut. So once we've done that, we can hit close. And right now I can either make a cut or command C to undo the cut
and hit Q on my keyboard, which basically will get rid of everything on the left side and make this the new start. Then how I usually work is I'm gonna just deactivate my video layer number 2 so I can see my A-cam. And then I'm just gonna play through this.
There you will learn how to edit a documentary style interview and make it look seamless in post.
And right at this point in time is where I'm gonna have a speaking pause and a big breathe
in post.
So what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna make a cut right when I stop speaking. So just cut that up. Then I move to the point in time where I begin speaking once again, and then I'm gonna hit Q, which then will get rid of everything that is to the left of the playhead until the next cut. Just like this. And if I wouldn't have a second video layer, this would just end up in a big, harsh jump cut.
As in post, even though you have two different...
So right now we can get rid of this part from video layer number 2. Just delete that and then move over to the playhead. Then activate the video layer number 2. And now just make sure that your snapping tool is off. You can either click the snapping tool or the magnet right here, or you press N on your keyboard to activate and deactivate it. Just make sure that it's deactivated because it lets you move your second clip a little bit smoother. Then I want you to go to the start of the second clip and just click this and bring that over by 2 frames. So this technique is called L and J cut cutting, and this makes everything look super smooth. Let's hit play, let's rewatch that and see if we have to make any more changes to that cut.
Seamless in post, even though you have 2 different camera angles.
That's pretty smooth. Let's now play this until we have the next speaking pause or we want to switch back to the main camera angle. Right here where I start speaking about the main camera angle or the A-cam is where I'm gonna do a cut. And what I'm gonna be doing now is I'm gonna deactivate video layer number 2. So now let's just watch this back and see if this looks good.
In post, even though you have 2 different camera angles, the first one, A-cam, is the Blackmagic.
Let's just bring that over a tiny bit until at around this point in time where my audio is getting a little bit louder. And this should look way better now.
Different camera angles. The first one, A-cam, is the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 6K.
This looks pretty good to me.
Which I'm recording this right now.
And right now I have a minor speak pause, so I'm gonna go here and make a cut. Then I'm gonna go to the start where I start speaking again. I'm gonna press Q to delete everything prior to this point until this cut, something like that. Then I'm gonna go to video layer number 2 and I'm gonna activate that. What I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna left click the second video layer and just bring that over by 1 or 2 frames. And let's just watch this back.
Okay, which I'm recording this right now. And the second camera is the Panasonic.
This is a pretty good example right now because I started speaking here, made the introduction, whatever. Then I started messing up and I started completely all over again at around this point in time. So what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna leave that all there because I'm happy with how this looks and how this sounds so far. Right here where I start to speak about my B-cam, I have to find that point in time right now. That's too far. And right here is where I start speaking about my B-cam and just get rid of this part. So just go to where the audio starts and then hit Q to bring that over. Right now, this should look good.
I'm recording this right now. And the second one, which is right up here, is the Panasonic Lumix G85.
That looks pretty good, even though those two are 2 completely different recordings or completely different takes of this part. So because I'm not happy with this cut, I'm gonna left click this cut and bring that over by 1 or 2 frames.
It's the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 6K, which I'm recording this right now. And the second one, which...
And this looks just super good. And right at this point in time, I'm gonna make another speak pause. So I'm gonna set a cut, deactivate my video layer number 2. And then, as you can see, I started messing up once again. As you can see, I just messed up a bunch of times to what I wanted to say. So I think around this point in time, all right, that's a good part. That's a good take. So I'm gonna zoom in here, go to the point where I start speaking, and then I'm gonna hit Q to bring everything else back to the playhead. Then bring that over maybe 1 or 2 frames to hide the cut. So just to overlap the video layer number 2 with the video layer number 1 by 1 or 2 frames. Mix G85. But first, if you want to edit and practice with me with the footage that I use in this tutorial and in the coming tutorials, feel free to join my channel membership program. There is where I'm having a big speak pause. So I'm gonna make a cut right here and then bring that over by hitting the Q key and activating video layer number 2. Bring that over just by 1 or 2 frames. Membership program, because alongside various other different benefits, all of my channel members will get a download link. That's super smooth. So actually that's super simple. Again, I don't know if that's the correct way to do, but I'm fine with having my clips stacked on top of each other and deactivating them and reactivating them once I need them. So that's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. I hope you learned something new. If so, please consider leaving a like, a comment, and a subscribe. That will mean a ton to me, but also don't forget to check out my new channel membership program. I'm sure you will like it. But with that being said, hope you all have a great day. See you in the next one. Bye.